We'll discuss some important concepts which are basically related to the chapter so-called circles, right? So before I get into the topics circles, let's see what are the concepts which are mainly useful while solving the questions, right? So I mean to say geometrical part of the circles. Okay, I'll give these concepts with complete explanation so that you can understand these concepts, and you'll try to see how these can be used in the plane geometry. Okay, let me start with the concepts that you know and little bit of confusion when you are reading that particular property. Very good. Look at here. So just let us start with the definition of the circle, right? What is basically a circle? A point which you have to fix, point to be clear, right? Point you have to fix where? In the plane, not in the space, right? You fix the point in the plane and set the distance of your choice, right? So suppose if I am setting this distance, collect all the points in the plane which are at a given distance from this particular point. So such points, if you collect, whatever the locus or whatever the curve that you are getting, that is called the circle, guys. All right, so you have to have the clear cut clarity. Circle means this, not entire this thing is called circle. Only the dotted ones that I marked here, that is called the circle. So what do you call the entire thing, sir? The entire thing is called the circular region. All right, so what is this fixed point is called? Center. What is this point? This point is called any point on the circumference, or you can call it as any point on the circle. So the distance that you are setting from this fixed point to this point, that is called the radius. So it's quite obvious. Suppose if I would have taken a point which is extremely diametric opposite of P, what do you call that? Q. This CQ is going to be twice the radius, because you have got the radius and you have got the radius. So it is equal to twice the radius. All right. So there are few terms which are related to the circles. I just wanted to talk about those concepts. Look here. If you have the circle, sir, instead of taking any points of the diameters, suppose I want to take any two points on the what? Circle, and I wanted to join those two. So what do you name this? Or how do you name this? Or what do you call this? So called terminology related to the circle. So this is called chord. AB is called the chord. And what do you call that PQ? PQ is basically called diameter. All right. Suppose, sir, if I extend both the points, see, I have taken the point here, I have taken the point here, I have joined this and extended. So maybe you can call it as something like CD. It goes even after intersecting the circle, right? So what do you call that? That is so-called secant of the circle. Secant of the circle. Sir, there is a point here. What? Suppose if the line is in such a way that it is just touching the circle and going. At which point it is touching? Let's say R, sir. Okay, fine. That's cool. So what do you call that? That is so-called the tangent. Tangent. Maybe let us take this point is T, so therefore TR is called the tangent, right? So let us discuss, this is basically something you need to know about the circle, right? So let us talk something about its area, circumference, sector, area of the sector, right? Length of the arc, all this. So firstly, I'll define those terms, right? And we'll talk about the geometrical or the use of those particular terms. Right. Suppose if I would have taken one more thing here, maybe let us take it as circle here. You take center of the circle, right, and join with the any two points here. The figure so formed, what is the figure that you could see? OAB, isn't it? So OAB is called what? Sector. So let's mention that OAB is basically the sector of the circle. What is it? It is bounded by two radii. And then this thing is called length of the arc, guys. Okay, so let us introduce the concept of angle. Whatever this arc are the corresponding, see, if I have the arc AB, then the corresponding thing is what? Chord AB. Sir, I can take AB this side also, no? Yes, you can take, no issues at all. So which one you mean to say? AB is a, which arc you are talking about? Are you talking about this arc, or are you talking about this arc? So if you want to have that clarity, see, you always can go with one more point here, maybe S. Then ASB you can call it as, no confusion is. So that is so called as the length, you could see it is minimum compared to AB. So therefore minor arc. So therefore ASB, whatever is called minor arc. Suppose if I would have taken here, let's take V. So AVB is called major arc. Major arc. Now see, this particular arc, I could say even this particular chord, because arc is corresponding to the circle, I mean chord. So whatever the angle it is making at the center, that is called denoted by theta. All right. So how is that angle is going to help us, sir? This angle is basically going to help us to find the area of the sector. Okay, fine. So what is the area of the sector? Area of sector AOB. Right, let's talk about AOB. First you tell me this thing. What is the total area? Pi r square, sir. Very good. If total area is pi r square, what is the angle made by the total total circumference at the center? Obviously 360. Now what is your contribution out of 360? Theta. Very good. So it is theta. Out of how much angle? 360. This part is out of how much area, guys? Out of pi r square, sir. Very good. So this is going to be pi r square. Okay, that's cool. That is nothing but theta by 360 into pi r square. But sir, we have seen some other formula. What is that? Area of the sector is equal to half r square theta, something of that kind. Okay, that's not a new formula. That will come from this only. Can you just help us, like, how will that come, sir? Watch here. This theta by 360, I am writing it as pi r square. All right, this is what I wrote here. And you want to see this one in terms of the formula that you already know, right? Okay. The 360, how do you write? Can you just help me in terms of the pi? So yeah, sir, it is 2 pi. Very good. Into pi r square. Pi and pi will get cancelled, isn't it? So this is half r square theta, right? Both of them are same. Like whatever the formula that you have here and this one, both of them are same. Generally know the formula is half r square theta. But that is same as this one, no confusion as such. Right. So we have seen the circle and we have seen the different terms which are related to the circle. Even the chord, secant, diameter, radius, circumference, right? Area of the sector, all this. Now what could be the circumference of the circle? See, the formula for the circumference of the circle would be taken this way. This is C is equals to 2 pi r. Right. Suppose, sir, the entire thing is 2 pi r, all right? So suppose if I wanted to talk about this particular length, that's basically the part of the circle. If I have to talk about this particular part of the circle, so how do I? See, once again, the same logic, guys. You take this as A and B, all right? What is the total angle which is made by the total circumference? How much angle it is making at the center, right? This is my center, isn't it? So total angle, which basically 360 degrees. Out of that, how much your required part is making at the center? Your required part is making at the center is an angle, let's take theta, right? Out of 360, your contribution is theta, isn't it so? So therefore, theta out of 360, that's basically my length of the arc. Theta out of 360. So theta out of 360 of the total length, isn't it so? So therefore, the total length is 2 pi r. Right? Okay. Now, what did I tell you? Whenever you say the arc, the corresponding part is what? Corresponding to arc, what will you be getting? You will always be getting this thing so-called chord of the circle. Right? If a chord is making an angle theta, I'm just moving to the next property, guys. If a chord is making an angle theta at the center of the circle, now my question is how much angle it can make at the circumference? Or other way around also you can speak. What is that, sir? If this chord is making an angle theta, where? At the circumference. What angle it can make at the center of the circle? Right? So let us see that. Precisely speaking, if angle ACB is equals to theta, then what could be your, call this as a O, then what could be your AOB? That is the question here. So try to interrelate. They always maintain constant ratio. No matter whether you take your C here or your C here, your C here, your C here. Anywhere from A to B in this arc, you take C anywhere, that angle will always make a constant ratio with the angle that it makes at the center of the circle. How, sir? Watch. So let's take this one in this particular direction. Your theta, let us divide into two parts. Okay, so call this as alpha and call this as a beta. Is that okay? Yeah. So call this as alpha and call this as a beta. Since this is radius and this is radius, this is alpha, so this also has to be alpha. Based on what property? If sides are equal, then opposite angles must be equal. So therefore, this is alpha, so this has to be alpha. This is beta, so this has to be beta. Okay, cool. How much is this angle then? So this is being a triangle, OAC is a triangle. So this is alpha and this is alpha. So this has to be 180 minus 2 alpha. Right? And how much is this? This is 180 minus 2 beta. So this part is 180 minus 2 alpha. This part is 180 minus 2 beta. So this part is turning out to be 2 alpha plus 2 beta. So that means angle AOB has become 2 alpha plus 2 beta. Isn't it so? So that is equals to 2 times alpha plus beta. Guys, just by looking at the diagram, can you just help me? What could be alpha plus beta? Yes, sir. Your theta, you divide it into alpha and beta. So if I add both of them, I will be ending up with theta. That's better. Just plug in here. So 2 times alpha plus beta is theta. What is that? You take any point at the circumference. This curve makes some angle at the circumference and some angle at the center. They always bear the constant ratio. In other words, if it makes an angle theta, let's say, then at center, it always makes twice of that angle. That's what I mean to say here. It has got a beautiful applications as well. But remember, the most of the students will get confused here. The reverse, I mean to say the converse of the statement is not true. What is a converse? Just think for a minute. What could be the converse? What is my statement firstly? My statement is, if a chord is making an angle theta, at the circumference, it does make 2 theta at the center. That's my statement. What could be the converse? Just think. I'll be providing one circle here. You can think of it and you can tell me. Converse could be this way. If a chord is making an angle theta at circumference, let's take at a point C, let's say. And if it is making angle 2 theta at the center, let's say, it is making theta at the circumference. Okay, for a clarity, I'll be mentioning this part here and I'll be mentioning this part. So let us call PQR, all right? Okay. PQR is theta and it is making 2 theta at some other point. Let's take that point is S. Now, what is your conclusion? Can I call S as a center of the circle? What do you say? Can I say S is the center of the circle? Don't come up with the statement, yes, may or may not be a center, right? What is that earlier statement? If it is making theta at the circumference, it does make 2 theta at the center, right? If it is making 2 theta, it may not be a center. Please have the clarity, right? So it can make one more point here, 2 theta. It can make one more point here, 2 theta. So all those may not be a centers. If you know it is a center, it will make 2 theta. If it is making 2 theta, it may not be a center. Right, so that's a one property where you need to have a lot of clarity, right? And otherwise you'll be getting into a trap where many questions can be framed on that particular concept. Okay, so this is one thing, and I'll be moving to the next property. You can just take a screenshot of this or you can have a look at this. I'll be going to the further part.